Hello everyone, this is Calvin Russell, CEO and founder of 850 Club Credit Consultation. Hope everyone's doing well today. Well, we got major news that just came out of the auto industry, and this is all about Santander, all right? So I actually got a follow-up video on how I stumbled upon this because I got an alert about this one yesterday, but one of the kind of ways I got some facts about it, and now it has been confirmed that Santander will be making major settlements to people who've been affected by their, I would say, shady practices as, you know, auto lenders. Now, when I sold cars, I sold cars for 6 years from 2011 to 2017. I was in sales, I was in management, and Santander was probably about the closest thing you could get to like pretty much not being approved at all, right? They had higher interest rates, the fees was crazy high, so the dealer had to pay a certain amount of money, the buyers had to pay a certain amount of money. It was ridiculous. But at the end of the day, a lot of people drove out with the car. Now, for some of you, you never had any issues with Santander at all. And also too, Santander honestly didn't just do high interest rate loans. They did a lot of low interest rate loans too. They're actually one of the largest banks, in different countries. It's just only in the US do they see a lot of their money making in the subprime market and different, areas where credit is just, I won't say just not getting started, but they actually do a lot of prime lending, in different, countries. But in the USA, listen, they most definitely make their money in the subprime industry, which is a nice word for bad credit. All right. But they do low interest rate, car loans as well, too. They kind of dabbled into that, but that is not the main source of their income. If less than 3 to 5%, and I know because not only do I see people's credit reports, but even when I was at the dealership, we had an opportunity to do what they call mailers, and we would do Santander mailers where they would go out to people who Santander had already kind of did a soft pull and could see what type of interest rate they could get them. Long story short, let's get straight to the point, right? If you had a repossession with Santander if you had a repossession between January 1st of 2010 all the way up until December 31st, 2019, they will give you, let me go ahead and pull this back up here. Okay, so they're going to actually pay $65 million in restitution to all of their subprime consumers. Because essentially people didn't have the right credit. They shouldn't have gotten approved for auto loans is essentially what attorney generals are saying. They should have said no, denied, instead of giving the people the loans when they know they didn't have the means to actually pay for it. Okay. But either way, they're going to give them $65 million. Now that's a lot of years, a lot of auto loans. So again, it's not going to be that much available, but you will, hopefully you get something, okay? But they're going all the way back to 2010, so that's a lot of people, man. That is a lot of people, all right? So that's if you defaulted on those loans. Defaulted means repossessed, okay? So if Santander has repossessed your auto loan, not only are they going to cut you a check, okay? We don't know how much that's going to be, but that's not even the best part. The best part is they're going to forgive the balance. Yes. So if you had a repossession between January of 2010 all the way up until December of 2019, they're going to forgive the entire balance. Now, you guys are probably saying, well, Calvin, if it was 2011, when I got the car, but then the car got repossessed in 2015, that's when the loan was closed. Now, 7 years from that point, let's say 2015, that will put you at 2022 for the fall off of your credit report. So some people may have already had it where if it has fallen off of their credit report and you'll just get the check. Okay, hopefully you get a check, right? But for some of you all who is still in your credit report as a repossession, you guessed it. They're going to zero out the balance. This is major, major news because I'm gonna be honest with you. Most of the repossessions that we see, a good 25%, 30% of the repossessions, That's the most. It's usually with Santander. And for them to zero out their balance, that's make that's listen, there are gonna be people who didn't qualify for homeownership that's now gonna qualify. There are gonna be people who couldn't get an apartment because they had that repossession, right? Been trying to get it removed. If you some of you all have been sued by Santander, okay, they're gonna pay all that back. All right. But the best thing is they're going to update it on the credit report as a zero balance. OK, and they're going to remove it from the credit report. All right. So this has been verified. Now, how long is it going to take? Man, I don't know. Mind you, this lawsuit has been going on since 2015. So they just made an arrangement on this in 2020. And it was actually the state of New York that made it happen. Of the 65 million, New Yorkers will get a guaranteed. Now, it says $2.7 million of the 65 mil. Okay. Now check this out. If you had, let's see here. So people who had their cars repossessed will get a balance forgiveness up to $433 million. Okay. Then, so they're going to clear out $433 million of people who had repossessions. Then, $65 million, completely separate figure, you're going to get a check back from them just because you had your car repossessed. Now, let's talk about the second area of people, because there's three areas. One is people between January 1st, 2010 through December 31st, 2019. The second area of people are people who are currently late. They're looking for your car, but they haven't taken it from you yet. Check this out. They're going to give you the title to your car and completely forgive the balance up to $45 million. So who's that list going to be? We don't know. So it's going to be random, right? So obviously they're going to start with the smallest balance. If they got any sense, they're probably going to start off with like the loans that are from the loans that have the smallest balances, and they kind of work their way up. But if you just got a loan with Santander, let's say a year ago, you probably not gonna get, because everything's just kind of doing it. So, here's another thing, you know, too. That's really the third area, the third gray area, okay? Is that what if you just got a loan with them 2 years ago, a year ago, you've been paying on time? Nothing's probably going to change for you, unfortunately, but I don't know. They may force Santander to change the terms and things of that sort, but I don't know, man, because you got to look up credit again, check stubs, all of that, you know. So it's only going to be for people who had their car repossessed in the past, or if they're looking for your car right now, they're going to give you the title. Okay, so obviously they're probably going to go with the lowest, balances first. That means people that may are already, their cars may be close to getting paid off or something like that. It doesn't say how old the loan has to be. They're just about a date range in general. Okay, so, but either way, the biggest thing is that they're going to be clearing out these balances, man, for people on their credit reports. That's major. So that includes payment history. That includes the balance itself. That includes the the account will be on the credit report, but they're going to clean up all the payment history. They're going to clean up the balance as well too. All right. They honestly do better just taking off people's credit reports, but obviously there's a lot of, you know, different parameters with that. So, but this is major, guys. A lot of automakers a lot of lenders don't do stuff like this, and it took some time, but that just goes to show you, if people keep fighting, then we will most definitely make things happen. The next thing we got to fight is now California's been working on this for quite some time. If a person pays a collection, it should get removed from their credit report. California's been pushing this for the past 2-3 years. It's a matter of time, and I think everybody should be on board with that. All right, so don't want to drag this video out any longer. If you like this video, like it. Want to share it, share it. I'll keep you guys posted on how you guys can do it, but there's nothing you need to do as of now. This is something that they're going to take care of. It's nothing that the credit bureaus can do. It's nothing you can dispute. You got to wait. See you on the next video.